Today, we're going to tackle a tough one, how to talk to your kids and coworkers, family and friends about things that scare you. And Dr. G is here to help us. Hi, Dr. G.
Hi, it's nice to see you, Emily.
You too. All right, let's start with kids. It's really hard to talk to kids about things that scare us.
It is. It's hard for two reasons. One, we don't want to cause difficult emotions in them. We have so much empathy for the kids in our lives, and bringing up something that is hard for us, we're sure it's going to be hard for them also. We're not always right, but we think it's going to be. And the other is we're afraid they're going to ask us a question that we don't have an answer to. And then what? And then what is, it's okay to not have all the answers. The most important lesson to that child in your life is that you're a good person to talk to about big, scary things. They can trust you.
Yeah. And so how do you answer them if you don't really have, if you don't know the answers?
There are a lot of ways to do that. But if your child says, well, why would that person do that mean thing? If you're talking about an act of terrorism, for example, then you might say, I don't know. How does it make you feel? And so you can focus on them on what you can help with, which is empathy and gratitude or action that you guys can take. You can focus on what you can control, because one of the best lessons for kids about big, scary topics is that there are things out of our control, but there are always things we can control.
Well, I like that. So you're basically saying, tell the truth. If you don't know, you don't know. And even if you do, well, just
telling the truth is super important, because if the point here is to teach kids to trust us, lying is the worst way to do that. They almost always figure it out. If not then, eventually they will figure it out. And we want them to know they can keep coming back to us, and that if we don't know, we'll work with them to find out what it's possible to find out.
I like that. Good point. All right. What about with your coworkers? Scary topics.
We have a hard time bringing up scary topics with kids for the reasons that we talked about. We have a harder time with adults asking uncomfortable or awkward questions. And it's because, for example, saying to someone that you're in line next to the store, could you take a step back, or could you pull your mask up over your nose? Or saying to a coworker, is it possible that you could use different language, because that felt a little racist to me? Or you can see how uncomfortable that would be. And here's the weird thing our brains do. It weighs that short-term tremendous discomfort as somehow more important than the long-term risk of not saying anything. So we think saying, could you cover your nose, and the fact that that might make that person embarrassed or angry or confrontational, is harder and more uncomfortable than the risk of catching an illness that could kill us or someone we love. When we think about it logically, we know that's not true. But in that moment, we go, I'll just not say anything.
Yeah, it's exactly how we feel. You just really broke it down there perfectly. So what can you do then?
The first thing is to ask yourself, is this a question of safety? So if I want to say to my friend who just got in my car, imagine we're in a world where friends get into cars. If I want to say, hey, could you put your seatbelt on? Because that's important to me and I don't want to be in an accident where this person might be hurt. But it's uncomfortable to say. So you think to yourself, this thing that I want to say that's uncomfortable, is it actually important? Is it a matter of someone's safety, mine or someone else that I care about? And if the answer is yes, then we just have to reason ourselves through it and say, this is uncomfortable, but uncomfortable is not the same thing as unsafe, and unsafe matters more. And then frame it, and these are the things you can control. Just like with kids, we have to think about, what can I control? I can't control their reaction, but I can control the context that I give. I'm worried about accidents and crazy drivers, so it would make me feel a lot better if you don't mind putting on your seatbelt. Another thing you can do is control your vocal tone to not sound sarcastic, judgy, nasty. Mm-hmm. Your facial expression, your body language, your eye contact, whether it's a stranger or someone you know well, the more you can put it on yourself and give them a chance to do you a favor, do you a kindness, rather than making them feel called out and judged, the more likely that you're able to get to the resolution you're hoping for.
All right, Dr. G, I feel like I just got therapy right now. Thank you so much. It makes me feel so much better. I'm not scared anymore.
Good. Fantastic.
All right. Thank you.